And he, oddly enough, what I remember about it is, was Stanley, me, and Nan Golden were all in the same class. And it was that kind of first class where everybody has to show their pictures, you know? And like, what have I been doing before I got here, you know? And Nan was always doing what she does now. I was kind of always doing street photography. And I do remember Stanley showed these pictures. He probably would hate me for saying this, but it was
he's gonna hate me.
I can't stop myself. It was a black and white photograph of a fire escape with like an orange and an apple, and then in red and blue. And we quickly pushed him off that path. Because everybody got there and they go like, oh, wait a minute, that's, you know. And the funny thing, I do remember, Stanley was like, he kind of bumbled along at the beginning because I borrowed film from him one day. And when I developed the film, his pictures were on top of my pictures.
There's a lot of power story.
I'm sorry. But he definitely, he found the best looking girl in the photos to tutor. And she was this girl, Nikki. But before her, Stanley was walking around going, like, telling us how, I think this was from back in New York, about this girl, Diane. I love Diane. You know, I love Diane. I miss Diane. I love Diane. All of a sudden, there was this Nikki. And we're going like, Stanley. You know, he would go, well, I love Diane, but I love Nikki. And when I heard that Stanley died, and I spoke to a couple of people who went to that school with me, they both emailed me, I love Nikki. And I emailed them back, you know, but I love Diane. But I knew Stanley from that really early stretch, and we sort of always bonded. I think the two of us, and looking back, I mean, if you subtract Nan, the two of us were like determined to be photographers, right? I mean, and we always were sort of watching each other over the years. I knew him up there, and Stanley by like 1975, 76, when he went out to you, I went down to New York and he went out to California to go to the Art Institute. But he did come to my wedding in 1979 and with a very pretty girl from California who everybody at my wedding was like, you know, she doesn't have a lot of clothes on. And it was a very like thin white Irish Boston, you know. But Stanley came and he like, you know, stood out place. And the thing I love about Stanley over the years is that, you know, when I went to New York, when I was in Boston, it was always like Stanley was like, you know, he was like, where are we getting our fry boots? Where are we buying our jeans? And he'd come in, you know, and he'd like look at me like, we're gonna both go have fry boots and jeans, right? And he came to New York and I was hanging out at CBGB's and he looked at me in like black straight leg jeans and sneakers, and he did that Stanley thing. You know, like, Dave, you're not dressed for us. And I was like, Stanley, this is the new thing. You know, and he like just looked at me like I was crazy. By the next time, he had black jeans and sneakers. And so we just kept track of each other over the years, and never really fell out of touch. And he's always, you know, what can I say? You know, the other thing I didn't know, remember when I went to Paris, and that's when you were there, and it was 88 when I went, and Stanley had been in Paris a couple of years, and he got a phone call, and he said, can you, this is Dave, I said, yeah. Sorry, I got to put the Stanley voice. Dave, he says, you got to help me on this phone call. I said, why? He goes, I can't tell what they're saying. I said, what are they saying? He's trying to find somebody at a hotel. He goes, I don't know, they're saying Posse C. I've been there 2 years. It means they're not there. So you never really did learn French.
I did. Huh? I was really shocked. Like years later, all of a sudden he was speaking French. I'm like, how did you?
He had a lot of franglais, but
well,
I guess
it's
not
true. I was really impressed. I think it was Carolee who.
Oh, maybe, yeah. But then the other deal with Staley, where was I going with that? I don't know. You know, he always had like the greatest heart, and he never, you know, never really forgot our great friendship. I think he used to tell people that, like, you know, Dave, we're like an old married couple. And I go, like, what are you talking about? I don't know what you mean by that. And,
about consistency. You were always, I mean, as far as I know, Staley, you've been in his life. So I think that sort of like.
It's the same for me. Yeah. I mean, Staley and I. You know,
Anna,
like,
you're much younger than David.
What's that?
You're much younger.
Oh,
and
here's
as
the
long as I know Staley, David was there.
Staley used to say to me, we'd have breakfast at Cafe Orla in East Village on a regular, every time he'd come in. And Staley would go, once at one point in the 90s or 2000s, Staley would go like, how old are you? And I'd go like, I'm 50, you know, he'd check my hairline all the time and he'd check my age. And he'd go like, how old are you?